Yeah.
Hello, everybody. I'm so happy to be able to send a message to you all. I miss you. I think you know that I was part of your initiative when it was launched a few months, maybe even some years ago. So congratulations to keep on going. I think that Think 2030 is key in order to facilitate a deeper understanding on what are the challenges about Europe in 2030 and how we can build a positive story out of that. Sustainable development, climate change challenges, and social and environmental issues at the very center of our decision-making process. So to ensure that prosperity and economic wealth is understood within the planetary boundaries, but also thinking on what are the benefits being perceived by any European citizen, what is our project in common for the time to come. I think that this is part of what we need to raise in the public agenda in the months to come. And I think that there are very good news that can be shared. Climate change action may be a good driver for that, but also the understanding on where the inequalities are growing and why, and how we can facilitate this clear relationship, this clear link between the access to the opportunities that the environmental services provide to all of us and the cost of covering the good wealth and the good health of our natural resources, and how we can facilitate these opportunities to any European citizen for the time to come. Just transition, sustainable consumption and production, climate, biodiversity, oceans, plastics, the way we consume, the way we produce, as I say, water, droughts, wildfires, are keywords that should be thought and anticipated with time enough to provide the right answers. And you all, the think tanks of the European member states, trying to build a common narrative and a common project are absolutely key in order to succeed.